Hello and welcome along to the second round of the Fun Cup here at Oulton Park. Well, the circuit is certainly a tricky one with rapidly changing presence and several tricky corners. This four-hour race is definitely going to be a good one. But before we head down to the pits, let's look back at the action at Silverstone with Chris Hartley.
A bumper entry of 32 cars were on the grid for the season opener as the Fun Cup continues to grow from strength to strength. After an impressive start, there was an early spin for the Jason Kennedy racing team from second place. Former champions Race Logic showed tremendous pace to build a huge early lead over Track Talk 2 Rent Dominoes, who are now up to second ahead of Lane Roofing Evolution. Last year's championship runners-up, Solutions Eco Racing, found themselves in a tight squeeze and headed for the Northamptonshire countryside. And after climbing from 32nd to 2nd, reigning champions JPR Yuvio got caught up with a bat marker and lost several laps in the pits, but were later able to recover to an excellent 8th place finish. Also dropping out of the top three were CCS Media with exhaust problems. And there was huge disappointment for Race Logic, who picked up a penalty for pitting outside of the window, scuppering what might well have been a dominant race win. That put DispatchBay.com into the lead and in search of their maiden victory, only for technical woes to put them out. With a few laps to go, Team Trooper Iron Maiden passed Team Honeywell to win at Silverstone, with two Rent Dominoes rounding out the podium. Second place at Silverstone was a hugely welcome result for Team Honeywell, as it was their first podium since 2015.
It was a long time coming. Last year wasn't particularly good for us with a few bits of bad luck and some mechanical issues, but I think, fingers crossed, this should be a good one.
Indeed. Now, it's a tricky circuit out there. We know that. There's lots of cambers, lots of corners to get your head around. Who's going first? What are the tactics?
Tim Hughes starts, puts in the Sterling first stint, keeps out of trouble, keeps on the lead lap, and then we sort of chip away during the course of the afternoon, and we'll see where we are after pit stop five.
Defending champions JPR Yuvio were fast at Silverstone, but didn't get the result they would have liked. So a good points haul here would be imperative to their title hopes.
I think you're down in P26, so you're going to have to battle the traffic again. Who's going out first?
We've got Farkini line up this time for the start, so you know, he's just as good as me, hopefully, at peeing his way through the pack. So fingers crossed we'll be up at the tail end, you know, pretty sharpish like last time.
And that was no kind of pressure, was it? Just that he'll be up at the front. Oh, that's great. Thank you.
Relative newcomers to racing are Team Brit.
I absolutely love Oulton Park. It's my favourite track, and I'm glad that the Fun Cup do two races in the season here. If you get in the groove around here, it feels amazing.
The temperature's dropping. It's making it easier to drive, but it's not making it warm out here, is it, Tab?
No, it's freezing, but it's good for the car because we don't have ventilation, you know, so we're nice and cool in the car. The guys are happy, I'm happy, and we've found a few seconds from yesterday, so it's going to be good.
You're bringing it home, so the actual pressure's on you.
Yes, not, yeah, definitely. I'll take all the glory, basically. Yeah, I'm happy with that.
At the other end of the experience spectrum are JPR on the piste, featuring multiple race winner Dom Jackson, with Graham Pattle and Mark Burton, who were the championship runners-up in 2013.
We love this circuit. It's one we always look forward to coming back to. I must admit, it's do a bit of historic racing as well, and it's a track that has plenty of challenges. If you look around it, there are different corners that require different skills and different challenges along the way. So, one of our favourites, I think.
We're starting mid-pack, so if we can move forward from there, stay consistent, stay out of trouble, then you know we'll see how things wash out. You know,
who's going out first?
Yeah.
And then?
Me in the middle.
Oh no, and then the pressure's all on you, Mark.
Yeah, I like the fun of finishing, because you know it can all come down to the last couple of laps if the safety cars are timed in the right way. So it gets quite intense.
After suffering engine problems at Silverstone, Track Focused will be hoping for a good result at a circuit where they've always been strong.
You're in the middle pack of the grid, so not a bad place to start.
Well, Sean's starting, so he doesn't stay in mid-pack very long. So we're expecting him to bring it in P1. So
no pressure at all. So how are you feeling? Are you feeling confident?
Looking forward to it. And if we get round and we don't bend it, then we'll be there or thereabouts, somewhere not too far behind the leaders, I suspect.
I see there's a bit of a mediocrity in terms of the damage here. Now, Sean, as the pressure is all on you, it's obviously a tricky circuit. You've been out for a while. How are you finding it?
Great. It's one of my favourite circuits. It's our home track, and we always go well here. We've always been quick. So, pressure. Yeah, basically.
After finishing sixth at Silverstone, the Drivers61.com team will carry one of our onboard cameras here at Oulton and should be amongst the front runners.
We made quite a few changes to the car before qualifying. Yesterday was a little bit hectic, but they all seemed to work and we were both a lot quicker.
Yeah, I think the pressure's on me. I mean, Scott's been doing this for a long time, as we all know. So I think the emphasis is really just on me not making any mistakes and just trying to bring it home in a decent position. So yeah, we'll see.
For the second season, all of the Fun Cup cars will run on all-weather GT radial tyres. And new for 2017, GT are also running their own car in the championship.
Two of the drivers in our championship this year are actually our test drivers from our European Technical Centre at Myra in the UK. And we've invited also some customers to come and enjoy testing the tyres with us and put them through their paces. It's something that's a really unique opportunity for them to say they've actually driven at a race circuit and actually on our tyres. We got some very good feedback from it last year. Performed under all conditions, and as far as we're aware, most of the Fun Cup drivers give it the thumbs up.
Well, as the cars pull up behind me, we've got 29 cars on the grid. Of course, Silverstone's winner is right at the back in 29th position. Well, we've got 4 hours of racing to go and 78 drivers to get through. So let's see the action.
The lights go out. Round two of the Fun Cup Championship gets underway. Rob Perry on pole in 171 Agua Caliente. But from the third row of the grid, it's Paul Turner in car 209 for Eco Racing that gets straight into the lead of the race at Old Hall. That's from fifth to first. In second place, then, the pole sitter. Third is Matt Jones for the 263 Team 7 car. But he loses the place at the bottom of Cascades to Clint Bardwell in the number 22 track-focused car. 169 is Dan Gullick for Team Lane Roofing. Good start as well, just behind from 7th on the grid for Nigel Greensaw as we go on board with Team Honeywell and Tim Wilden trying to come out from 13th on the grid. He's alongside Sean Cooper here as they go on the brakes on the way to the Shell Oils corner and goes around the outside on the exit to the turn, but then runs wide and loses the place again coming up to the chicane. And then you've got Charlie Kennedy trying to come around the outside of him. It's three abreast here almost. Who's going to make it first? Wilden gets there. Cooper's ahead of him on the grass and losing a position is the Charlie Kennedy car. And at the head of the field, they come thundering over Hilltop for the first time in the race. And there is Nigel Greensaw, number 248, gaining another place as Matt Jones slips backwards. A good start as well for the blue 252 car of the former champions, John Tomlinson, for Race Logic. And there are the race one winners from Silverstone, Paul Whiten for Team Trooper Iron Maiden. Because they won the first race, they have to start right at the back of the field as we go on board now with Scott Mansell. I reckon that was Chris Hart coming alongside him in the 106 Track Talk to Red Domino's car, which is coming from 28th on the grid. So Chris has had a good start as they come into Lodge Corner for the first time. Rob Perry has lost a place, but he's still going to be second at the end of the first lap of racing here at Oulton Park. Team Agua Caliente, one of the new outfits for 2017 in the Fun Cup. Keep an eye to the red and blue CCS Media car. I think Nigel Greensaw, yes, has gained another place on the way into Old Hall. As we see Tim Wilden waving by Farkini. So that is from 26th on the grid up to 12th place for Farkini in the JPR UVO car. Scott Mansell is overtaken by Chris Hart. So Chris now up to 14th place from 28th on the grid. Another one trying to come through the back of the grid is Richard Webb, who started 27th and off, I'm afraid. That's the 312 Team Brit 2 car of Tav Kirk. That is at the front of Cascades, but he rejoins. So superb start for Paul Turner for Solutions Eco Racing. Likewise for Nigel Greensaw in second place. And likewise for John Tomlinson in the blue 252 car. He's just gone around the outside of Clint Bardwell for third place. Then you got 221, Andy Bicknell for DispatchBay.com. Then a fabulous start for Farkini. And look at this for a move around the outside from Scott Mansell, who goes gunning around the outside of Charlie Kennedy on the way into the chicane. Well, a very lively start to the race. We're on to lap number 5 here at Oulton Park, and the leader has been caught, and Nigel Greensaw dives down the inside on the way into Lodge and relieves Paul Turner of the race lead. So we've got a third different leader already. You've got John Tomlinson just behind as well, looking very menacing in the Race Logic car, which utterly dominated the first half of the race at Silverstone. And John now sweeps down the inside and goes second on the way into Old Hall. So it's from first down to third place for Paul Turner, up to fourth place for Bicknell. Fifth from the back of the grid is Chris Hart, and into the pit with dramas early on, I'm afraid that is Charlie Kennedy in the 104 car. And another spin and another Team Brit car. This time it's the 158 entry of Peter Van Smeren on the way out of Old Hall Corner.
back on board with Scott Mansell, and out wide goes Dan Gullick in the 169 car. You've got Team Honeywell alongside as well. Dan gathers it back together but loses a place because he lost traction, and Scott goes through, and here we go side by side here for the lead of the race on the way down into the chicane. Who's going to get there first? Nigel Greensall just about fends off John Tomlinson, and again charging around the outside, the last of the late breakers, Scott Mansell on Team Honeywell. He's got the pole sitters just ahead as well, as Rob Perry begins to fall backwards, and around goes Dan Gullick, a full 360, but that was beautifully gathered up, and he will rejoin, but he will lose three or four places. It was a change of splitter, a new bonnet onto the car for Charlie Kennedy, so he goes out. He is a long way down the order, but crucially, he is still on the lead lap. Now we've got a group of five cars battling for the lead of the race here. Out of the lead group is Paul Turner for Eco. That car is slowing, and it's three abreast for second place almost. It's John Tomlinson that stays second. Then Andy Bicknell in the orange and black dispatchbay.com car. Chris Hart got squeezed and might lose a place on the way out of the corner. Joining this group as well is Scott Mansell in the 188 car from 20th on the grid and into the pits. With a drama goes the former race leader, Paul Turner. Here again, it's wheel-to-wheel into Old Hall Corner. You've got Nigel Greensall battling against his old teammate John Tomlinson. They both won title together, and out one onto the grass goes Varchini for JPR. Juvio takes out a marker board and loses several places. That's the 188 car of Scott Mansell that's been carrying the onboard camera that gets past as well. That was a hairy ride. Let's have a look again from Scott's car. Varchini squeezed out onto the grass, and woo, breathe in, Mansell just about made it through. Oh no, the pole sitter's had a moment now. That is Rob Perry in the Agua Caliente cars. So that's going to drop right down the order, but he'll get going again. And a drama as well for Chris Weatherall in the team that's fourth in the championship after round one. Team Lane Roofing Evolution in for an early unscheduled stop as John Tomlinson goes on the attack for race logic, but he can't find a way through. He runs out of road. He goes down the escape route. He slaloms his way back through the obstacle course, and he's going to lose several positions here as we head for a break. Welcome back to Oulton Park, round two of the Fun Cup. There's the former race leader, Paul Turner for Eco Racing. He pitted with a problem before the break. He's now almost a lap down as we see a change of lead. Stabbing one down the inside later on the brakes. Chris Hart for Track Talk 2 Red Dominoes getting ahead of Nigel Greensall. Here is Paul Whiten from the very back of the field for Team Trooper. Now up into the top half of the field. This is a scrap side-by-side for 11th place. Tom Jackson in the 99 JPR on the Peace car, just about fending off Marcus Batty, who locked up the brakes in the 21 machine. There's the pole sitting car of Agua Caliente, number 171. Rob Perry being forced out wide here. He had a spin earlier on. He's just lost another place there. That is to Steve Walton for Track Talk FNS. So now we've got 6-7 for the lead of the race, nose to tail, not for the first time in Fun Cup. There at the back of the group is the Race Logic car, which was going for the lead and then at this very corner ran wide a couple of laps ago. You go aboard now with Scott Mansell in the lead group, who is having a look at the paddle shift. I think he's got a slight problem with that. He's been fiddling around with it a couple of times, but he's still very quick. And there is the Iron Maiden car. It's got ahead of Marcus Batty now, and he's weaving around trying to find a gap, find a way past Dom Jackson. But Dom, a very experienced racer, is able to keep Paul Whiten behind him. So the championship leaders trying to make their way up the order. If you win a race, you have to start at the back. That is the disadvantage, but Paul doing a solid job. And in amongst the leaders, there's drama. So that is two Red Dominoes kicking up dust. Next through is the Scott Mansell car. Then it's Race Logic, and in the background, going very, very slowly, that is Track Focused. And late through as well is CCS Media. So there's been a drama up at Old Hall Bend. Scott Mansell has gained quite a few places as a result of that. And up into the top three now, but from third place, Sean Cooper stops the Track Focused car with damage. Here's a replay. It was into Old Hall, and there was a coming together, a spin. Nigel Greensall went around. On the grass went Scott Mansell, on the grass went Chris Hart, and slowing there, he whizzed past the Sean Cooper car. So that's brought the safety car out. The first mandatory pit stop window is opened, and that means everybody is going to dive into the pits more or less. So a real race here between the pit crews, and with no minimum pit stop time, this is where they can make a real difference. Everybody has made their first round of pit stops then, and it is Track Talk 2 Red Dominoes that lead the way. Up to second place is dispatchbay.com. So Henry Dawes leading now from Marcus Clutton, but a few of the cars were late to come in, and one of them was the Team Lane Roofing car.
Daniel, now you're one of the last to pit. Tell us what happened there.
I didn't hear it on the radio, so I had no idea that everyone... I had an idea that people were coming in, but I thought, I didn't hear it. I didn't see it at the pit window, so luckily, Ed, in the last call, called me in, so I come in.
Hey, well, it's been a hectic grid out there. How was your first stint?
I had a good tap on the first bend, which I wasn't too happy about. It took me off a bit of a spin, but hey, that's racing.
Back on track, a huge cloud of dust at Lodz because the dispatchbay.com car has gone off from second place. Safety car deployed once more. And so that will give us a chance to catch up with some of the drivers that were involved in the incident that brought out the first safety car.
Unfortunately, Nigel went in on eco at turn one, hit him pretty hard in the side of the wheel, sent him sideways. I braked and I think track focus hit the back of me pretty hard, which has probably burst his radiator.
I was sitting third, right behind Chris, and then Nigel Green saw him first. We caught a back marker. Nigel tried to go past him at turn one. They made contact at the apex. Nigel then sort of was spinning in the middle of the corner. Chris, who I was tucked up behind and blind at that point, braked in the middle of the corner. I hit Chris, which broke our radiator, and then narrowly missed a spinning Nigel.
They've tried and tried, but they can't get the dispatchbay.com car out of the tyre barriers. So Marcus Clutton has to get out of the car. And back in the pit lane, Kyria's managed to catch up with Paul Turner to find out why he had to make an early unscheduled pit stop.
Basically, our hub nut come loose, and that was then creating the brake disc to push the calipers out. So my brake pedal was getting longer and longer, and we struggled with that, had to come in. We got that sorted, and then just tried to stay on the lead lap.
Back to the battle for the race lead. Track talk, two red dominoes. Henry Dawes under attack from Graham Roberts. JPR Yuvio down the inside on the way into Lodz Corner. And a new race leader all the way from 26th on the grid because of all these safety cars. Everybody's remaining bunched up. Just to the back of the top 10 has dropped the driver 61.com car of Richard Baxter and Scott Mansell. Just outside the top 10, all the way back from 25th on the grid. Team Viking having a really good run. But I'm afraid there are problems into the pits for Race Logic. And another team who had an extra pit stop, a Mack Racing, who finished in the top six at Silverstone.
Went into the wall, so the steering is now off, and there's no mirror on the left, so I keep getting mugged on the left, you know, because as you're turning in, you think, is there someone? Oh, yeah, there is. Yeah, so it's a bit tricky driving at the moment.
Another team that went really well at Silverstone was the Fun Cup Academy car, 195 of twins Chris and Ed Bridle. They're joined this weekend by Chris Dovolt, just outside the top 10 once again, with the sister car of Danny Henry, Jay Shepherd and Matt Jones just behind as well. That started near the front of the grid. Now, we go on board with Harry Mailer, a new recruit to Team Trooper. And here he is, and he is at the head of the field. He's found a way past the number one car of JPR Yuvio. Still just behind them, you've got two red dominoes. And in fourth place now is Team Honeywell. So it's all bunched together at the head of the field once more. There's the 99 car of JPR on the piste. And just behind them in sixth place, going really well, is the 170 car of Truman's.
A lot of people coming off the track. So for us, we've made a real promise to ourselves this time we're going to avoid making mistakes. Now, there have been one or two, but they haven't been too serious. But what we've done this time is stayed out of trouble. And it's done as well, because we're not normally running in the top 10, and we're pretty happy to be doing that.
Back to the leaders, and they've switched around again. Farchini back ahead of Harry Mailer. Up to third, look in the background, his Team Honeywell. Down to fourth, Track Talk 2, Rent Dominoes. But after two really strong performances by Team Race Logic, it's been another disappointing day.
We did a really quick stop, started the engine. We pushed the car so it's rolling. But unfortunately, when Julian put it in gear, it slipped the cam belt. And so it was instantly not running properly. We managed to crawl back to the pits, but it's clear the engine's gone.
Meanwhile, Old Hall Corner has proven to be a slippery customer over the last couple of laps. First of all, we had the JPR GT radio car going around and others going off the road. Then we had the DFDC car running way, way out wide. And a lap later, having just survived the previous lap, the Team Viking car spun around and was facing in the wrong direction. That's quickly being cleared up. And at the head of the field, JPR Yuvio have really begun to get the hammer down. Now, Graham Roberts extending his advantage into the Team Trooper car is Jake Rattenbury, the GT racer. They're in second place. The Welshman spending much of his time this season driving a Lamborghini Huracan, so something a bit different for him here. Dropping down towards the tail end of the top 10, though, are Track Talk 2 Rent Dominoes, because they have suffered an exhaust problem, but they're going well now and catching everybody back up. And down at Jason Kennedy Racing, Kiri's caught up with one of our new drivers.
Okay, James, just got out of car 104. You're sort of travelling at the back of the grid a little bit. It's tough out there.
It is, yeah. It's my first Fun Cup. It's just, yeah, there's something else. It's great. Yeah, so just staying out of trouble today, getting through in one piece.
Trying to stay out of trouble. Like you said, it is so busy out there, isn't it?
Yes, yeah. Yeah, luckily my partner Charlie, he's doing well, so he's making the time I'm losing. But no, other than, yeah, great, just loving it.
After running in the top eight for the first half of the race, the track focus two car of Clint Barnwell and Dean Warriner has had a problem and dropped back. But going from the back of the field well up into the midfield now, our Track Talk FNS.
We had a bit of trouble with the car this morning. Obviously, we had a bad start position as well, so but we've worked our way up. And so the car's working all right at the minute. A few hustles and bustles with other cars touching, but it's part of the game, isn't it? So
it's very busy, very competitive.
Yeah, it's just a tight track, so. But yeah, it's fully enjoyable. Really enjoyed it.
We're into the final phase of a four-hour race, and look, they are all still together for the lead. There is JPR Uvio, couple of lengths back and back to second place now, Track Talk Tourette Dominoes. Henry Dawes aboard, he took his first ever win here at this circuit, but right behind his former BTCC Championship runner-up, Anthony Reid, for Team Trooper. Fourth place now, number 41, Team Lane Roofing Evolution. They made a tremendous comeback after an early pit stop. Likewise, our Eco Racing Solutions are in fifth place. They were down to 27th position at one point and still running in the top six. We've got Truman's. This car was running in the top six, but I'm afraid a broken throttle cable in the penultimate stint put Team Honeywell out of contention as we see a stab up the inside for second place. Anthony Reid taking no prisoners on the way into Lodge Corner. He knew he needed to get on with it because he can see, with the laps running out now, the race leader stretching his legs, Graham Roberts getting away. Both Team Lane Roofing and Team Viking have had spins in this race but are in the top 10. Likewise, the JPR Motorsport car of Mark Owen returning to the championship, Dave Clark and Christian Rose. There's that squabble going on for fifth place, still nose to tail, but somebody's off the road. Oh no, it's from seventh place. It's the driver61.com car of Richard Baxter, buried in the gravel trap. Into the Lodge Corner for the final time. He's been able to fend off Anthony Reid, and it's going to be a first race victory of the season for JPR Uvio. It's still mighty close for second place, but there is the checkered flag, and it's a win for the defending champions, Graham Roberts and Farchini. Second place goes to Team Trooper Iron Maiden from the very back of the grid, and on the podium once again for Track Talk to Red Dominoes. Excellent comeback for Evolution and Eco Racing. Truman's with their best ever drive in sixth place, and the team of the day, a Team Viking.
Arkini Graham, that was well earned. Well done.
Oh, thank you. That was hard, nail biting, but yeah, absolutely brilliant. We just kept our heads, kept pounding the lap times in, and it came to us.
And obviously, the safety car just before pit stops closed it all right up, and then I knew Anthony would be jumping in the Team Trooper car, and for him to come out right by me, I thought, oh my gosh, I'm going to have to get right in the zone here and get my head down, try and pull a gap to him. And luckily, I didn't get a gap, but I just managed to keep him at arm's length.
Well, it's been a fantastic day of racing here at Oulton Park with 4 hours of on-track time, 5 pit stops and 1 eventual winner, JPR Uvio. Well, that's all from us here at Oulton Park. We move on to Brands Hatch. We'll see you next time.